What is the difference between yok and değil in Turkish? What I see from most of my students, they mix them together a lot. If you cannot differentiate them as well, watch this video till end. We use değil to define things in a negative way in Turkish. Ben şimdi parktayım ama park kalabalık değil, hava sıcak değil, bu yüzden mont giydim. And we use yok for non-existence. Ben parktayım ve parkta kedi yok, köpek yok, çok fazla insan yok. If you understand it, save this video for later and give me an example in the comments.
You are learning Turkish but you can still understand what you are hearing. Here is the reason. Turkish is a language that is read as it is written but not all the time. How do you read that? It is not ne yapıyorsun. It is ne yapıyorsun. Ne yapıyorsun. What about that one? Are you reading this as geleceğim? We say geleceğim. Geleceğim. Or sometimes they say geleceğim. Let's take a look at this sentence. There's an harmony in every single language, right? So is Turkish. We don't read it one by one. We read it as if this is one word. Ben armut istiyorum. Ben armut istiyorum. If a word ends with a consonant and the next word starts with a vowel, you read it as if it is one word. That's it. Now follow me and save this video for later if you find it helpful.
Arabayı böyle kullanma, arabayı böyle hızlı kullanma. İkisi de olur. Böyle hızlı kullanma, yok çabuk olmaz burada, gerek yok. Çok korktum. Arabayı böyle hızlı kullanma ya da böyle kullanma, bravo. Bak, böyle, şöyle. Değil mi? Öyle, böyle, şöyle, bu şekilde kullanabilirsin.
Evet. And you can, when you write the examples, it's like öyle, like this. You're showing me.
Ümit, öyle konuşma. Öyle söyleme. Değil mi? Ümit bir şey söylüyor. Öyle söyleme. Böyle yapma.
Don't say this. Don't.
Don't say like this.
Like this.
Don't say so.
Here are the Turkish translation of some very famous English songs. To go easy on somebody. That means birine hoşgörülü davranmak ya da birine yüklenmemek in Turkish. To paint the town red, that means gecelere akmak, alem yapmak in Turkish. To lose the religion means dinden imandan çıkmak in Turkish. I can't get you out of my head, that means seni aklımdan çıkaramıyorum in Turkish. Bir kişiyi aklından çıkaramamak. If that video was helpful, support me. Like, share and comment. One of my followers asked me why in Turkish we say sütü, there is ı. Why we say kapıyı, there is ı. I couldn't find the comment but I hope you are gonna see this video. If you want to learn Turkish, you should know what is vowel harmony in Turkish. We have vowel harmony. What does that mean? Let's take a look at these words. Sütü, kapıyı, kediyi, telefonu. As you can see, all of them has a different ending. It's because of the vowel harmony. Which means if a word ends with a, ı vowel, you should put ı. If it ends with e, i, you're gonna need i. If it ends with o, u, you should put u. And ö, ü, it needs ü. Now I have a question. Why there is ye for kediyi and kapıyı? Answer it in the comments.
What is the difference between kusura bakma and kusura bakmayın? So kusura bakma is for sen. In Turkish we have ben, sen, o, biz, siz, onlar, right? Kusura bakma, sen kusura bakma. Kusura bakmayın, siz kusura bakmayın. First context might be a formal context. Second one might be more than one person. So you in both ways, you know, formal or more than one person. Rica ederim. And if you guys have more questions,
if you have just started learning Turkish, the thing that challenges you the most are the vowels. As a Turkish teacher who has 7 years of experience in teaching Turkish as a foreign language, now I'm gonna give you some pair of words. Listen them carefully and try to understand the difference. An, en, on, ön, un, ün. Let me give you one more example. Kal, kel, kol, köl, kul, kül. The point here is the pronunciation, not the meaning. Some words doesn't even have a meaning. Now take a pen and paper, try to write the words by just listening. Let's see how... Today I'll give you some pronunciation tips in Turkish. I have a headache, but don't worry, I'll make this video because everything is for you to learn Turkish, guys. First tip is bir. Even if in Turkish we write bir elma, bir su, bir çay, we do not pronounce re. We say bir su. Pardon, bir çay alabilir miyim? Bir çay, bir elma. Second one is future tense. We write geleceğim, but we say geleceğim. We write yapacağım, but we say yapacağım. We write söyleyeceğim, but we say söyleyeceğim. Third one is present continuous tense. For ben and biz, we pronounce re. For example, geliyorum, geliyoruz. But other than ben and biz, we write again, but we do not pronounce. For example, geliyorsun. Do not say geliyorsun. Geliyorsun. O geliyor. Siz geliyorsunuz. Onlar geliyorlar. If you find that video helpful, send this video to one of your friends who is learning Turkish.
What is the difference between tanışmak and buluşmak in Turkish? When you translate tanışmak in English, it will tell you to meet. When you translate buluşmak, it will tell you to meet. But what is the difference? Most of my students are mixing them up. So basically, tanışmak, when you meet somebody for the first time and you introduce yourself. Like, merhaba, benim adım İpek. Hi, I'm İpek. What's your name? Nice to meet you. This is tanışmak. Buluşmak is meeting with somebody you already know. For example, you have a friend, Ayşe. Ben dün Ayşe ile buluştum ve kahve içtim. Yesterday, I met with Ayşe and we had a cup of coffee. So, if you meet somebody you already know, this is buluşmak. If you meet somebody and you introduce yourself, this is tanışmak. Now save this video if you find it helpful and follow me for more.